Hello, I'm Murray Sidman. About a year ago, Davidson Films asked me if I would help them to prepare and narrate a film about the life and accomplishments of B.F. Skinner. He taught us that we are what we do, but more to the point, he taught us that we can change what we do for the better.
I remember when I first started working with rats in my first experiments, I would arrange an experiment, and I would expect to get a certain shaped curve. I wouldn't get that, and I would get so furious. Why don't you do what you're supposed to do? And then I realized finally, nature to be commanded must be obeyed. The rat is always right.
Skinner at Harvard was soon putting his mechanical skills to work. Skinner proposed that the critical relation between behavior and environment can be conceived of as a contingency of reinforcement. Contingent means dependent on. It defines an if-then relation. If the pigeon in this chamber pecks the lighted disc, it then gets food. This pigeon's behavior has been shaped into ringing a bell by requiring closer approximations to the desired behavior before giving it food. The second thing Skinner realized was that the sequence of events here was just the reverse of what happened in Pavlovian conditioning. Pavlov got his dog to salivate in response to a stimulus, the metronome. Pavlov's and Watson's work led to a stimulus-response psychology that many have recognized as too simplified and mechanistic to account for the great variety of human behavior. But Skinner got his animal to peck a disc not by presenting it with a stimulus beforehand, but instead by presenting a consequence afterward. The important event here was the food that came after the animal pecked the disc. This was no longer stimulus-response psychology. If anything, it was response-stimulus psychology. By adding the third term, discriminative stimulus, to the reinforcement contingency, along with response and consequence, Skinner greatly broadened the applicability of operant conditioning. The three-term contingency is the basic unit of operant behavior. Now, Skinner's work was about behavior, initially that of lab animals, but with more and more applications to humans in ever larger groups. Although the focus of his science was always on individuals, his later writings dealt with how we, through understanding our own behavior, could restructure social systems to improve life for ourselves and for the planet Earth. Skinner's interest in how environments shape human interactions and how human life can be improved by the application of behavior analysis can perhaps best be seen in his own environment, a basement study which he designed to support the writing that was the focus of his life. He was his own best human subject.